Hey everyone, Russ Barkley back again with some more comments on the relationship of ADHD to childhood trauma and maltreatment, as well as more general childhood adversities. This comment is precipitated by the fact that just a couple of months ago, a physician from Canada by the name of Gabor Mate was interviewed on live television, during which he, by the way, diagnosed the Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex, with ADHD, among other disorders, based entirely on having read Harry's autobiography. I don't want to get into the ethics and the recklessness of doing such things based on secondhand information. But the point I want to make here is during this interview, he once again proclaims that ADHD is entirely the result of exposure to early childhood stress and trauma. And he says that that certainly was the case with regard to Prince Harry, particularly regarding the loss of his mother during early childhood. You can go to Attitude Magazine, to their website here, and you can see their take on all of this, along with a review of the experts that they interviewed concerning this particular aspect of Mate's claims about Prince Harry and about ADHD arising strictly from a normal response to normal stress. He also claimed that you can heal ADHD without medication. Mate has written a book earlier on ADHD, and by the way, let me just stop for a moment and apologize for mispronouncing his name in my earlier post on trauma, but that said, it doesn't take away from the unscientific basis to these propositions that he is making, not only about Prince Harry, but especially with regard to early childhood stress and trauma experiences, and later ADHD. So go over to Attitude Magazine and attitude.com. Have a look at this article from March about this issue. You're going to read more about Mate's proclamations about ADHD. But the point here is that there is not a shred of scientific evidence to support his thesis that ADHD arises solely from exposure to stress and other childhood adverse events. It just simply isn't the case. Mate is engaging in what I call conceptual hydroplaning. By that, I mean that he has long ago, with his opinions, left the empirical road surface of scientific evidence and simply gone on now to be a celebrity who can make proclamations about psychiatric disorders, in this case about ADHD, without having his ideas tested against the large body of scientific evidence that's out there. And indeed, testable it is. As I said in my earlier post, there are hundreds of twin studies that we can use to compute the genetic contribution to human traits, and in this case, to ADHD. And those twin studies have reliably demonstrated that ADHD is among the most heritable, that is genetically influenced, of all psychiatric disorders, and that the vast majority of variation in ADHD traits in the human population is accounted for by genetic variation in people. There is virtually no or little contribution of rearing environment in these twin studies, known as shared environment, to the ADHD trait, and a very small contribution of unique or non-shared events. And those events can be difficulties during pregnancy, difficulties with delivery, such as premature delivery, exposure to lead during early childhood, as well as later, as I've said before, exposure to traumatic brain injuries. So all of those factors would fall under the non-shared environment computation. So we can safely say that 75 to 80% or more of the variation in ADHD is the result of genetic variation, and that the remainder appears to be the result of exposure to biological hazards in the environment. But Mate appears not to have gotten the memo on this and ignores the hundreds of thousands of studies on the neurobiology, genetics of ADHD, and so on, and instead continues to make these kinds of ridiculous proclamations about ADHD arising from stress. So let me just illustrate the case that I'm making here from a particular study published less than a year ago in the Journal of Child Psychology and Psychiatry. You can see it here. And this is a study on the role of children's and their mothers' ADHD genetic risk, measures of household chaos, and then the children's ADHD symptoms as well. And what they're doing here is looking at the correlation between genes and environment. And what does this study of a very large sample, over 2,200 twins that were followed longitudinally, what does it have to say? Well, what it shows is that children who were raised in more chaotic households certainly had higher rates of ADHD symptoms. However, both the mothers and the children's genetic risk scores explain the variation in chaos in the household, particularly the child's ADHD genetic risk score, along with the child's ADHD symptoms, had a major effect on the level of chaos in the home. This is the point I made earlier in my post, that there is a reciprocal interaction going on here between the child having effects on the parent, parents having effects on kids. If parents also have ADHD, that feeds back to produce more chaos in the family, might even increase risk for oppositional and conduct disorder. But the fact is, both people in this equation have high risks for ADHD, and as this study shows, it's the ADHD genetic risk that entirely explains the subsequent chaotic households. There are other studies like this that also looked at specifically child abuse and neglect, again using large samples of twins followed longitudinally, and find that there is no evidence that early abuse and neglect predict later ADHD once you control for the child's level of ADHD at the starting point, as well as controlling for their genetic risk and the parent's genetic risk. So all of this is simply to make the same point I made earlier, that the relationship between ADHD and early childhood stress, trauma, adversity, and maltreatment is a complex one. But it is not this simplistic thesis of Mate's that ADHD is entirely explained by stressful life events. Instead, what we see is a large genetic contribution to ADHD, in which ADHD then makes a contribution to chaotic households and to risk of being subsequently abused or maltreated or neglected, and that can feed back to make the ADHD child symptoms worse, particularly physical trauma, and those can go on to increase risk for oppositional and conduct disorder. But the ADHD is not arising de novo from exposure to stress. So you can use Google Scholar, you can find the hundreds of studies that I'm talking about that illustrate this complex interplay, but also show that before we can render any definitive conclusions, our studies have to be genetically informed, controlling for the genetic risk of ADHD in the parent, the genetic risk of ADHD in the child's early childhood ADHD going forward, and then all of that probably or possibly leading to an increase in exposure to adversity, maltreatment, and stress. So thanks for joining me today. I just wanted to add a few more comments as well as apologize for the mispronunciation of Mate's last name, but that doesn't change the fact that these ideas are unscientific and utterly ridiculous. So thanks again. Hope to see you around this channel soon. Be well.